We often don't think about how quickly a seed grows, depending on the seed, and what is involved. We know it has roots, stems, and leaves, but there are many moving parts involved for everything to occur. With these radish seeds, we see an initial radicle come out that forms the first root. How does it know which way is down? Then we see these fuzzy root hairs puff out, and later the roots branch out and the stem with its initial leaves grow upward. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video, I will talk about the internal structure of roots. Roots grow from an apical meristem at the tip. The root apical meristem is protected by the root cap. Just behind the root cap and root apical meristem is a short zone of elongation. These cells undergo division and expansion. The root hair zone is a region in which many of the epidermal cells extend out as narrow trichomes. It increases the root's surface area. Imagine that roots that are at least 100 micrometers in diameter are too wide to penetrate many pores in the soil. Root hairs, being only 10 micrometers in diameter, can enter most crevices and extract water and minerals from it. Behind the root hair zone are lateral roots. Lateral roots may occur in rows or appear to be randomly distributed on the parent root. Whereas the shoot apical meristem is protected by either bud scales or young, unexpanded foliage leaves, the root apical meristem is protected by a thick layer of cells, the root cap. Although some soils appear soft and easily penetrable on a microscopic scale, all contain sand grains, crystals, and other components that can damage the delicate apical meristem and root cap. Because the cap is forced through the soil ahead of the root body, it is constantly being worn away and must be renewed by cell multiplication. In the root cap, cells in the central portion, A, divide so that two daughter cells are aligned and with the root and the root cap grows forward. On the edges, B, cells divide and expand in such a way that cells flow radially outward. Maturing cells detect gravity using starch grains that settle on the lower side of the cell. With production of auxins, some cells elongate faster than others to position the root downward. Close to the edge of the cap, the cell's dictyosomes secrete mucigel. The middle lamella breaks down and releases the cells. It has been estimated that only 4 or 5 days pass from cell formation in the root cap to its sloughing off, so it is always regenerating itself. If the root apical meristem is examined in relationship to the root tissues it produces, regular files of cells can be seen to originate in the meristem and extend into the regions of the root tissues. There is a mitotically inactive central region known as the quiescence center, indicated by these roots that were grown in a solution with a radioactive precursor of DNA showing where the action is. It can replace the apical meristem if it becomes damaged. Just behind the root apical meristem itself is the region where cells expand greatly. Some meristematic activity continues, but mostly cells are enlarging. This zone of elongation is similar to the shoot's subapical meristem region. Cells begin to differentiate into a visible pattern, although none of the cells are mature. Here, cells are enlarging. Nuclei becomes less distinct, and protoderm, provascular tissue, and ground tissue begin to differentiate. Zone of maturation root hair zone is marked by the production of root hairs growing outward. This increases the absorption of water and minerals. The tissues are differentiated and cortex cells transfer minerals from the epidermis to the vascular tissue by diffusion through the walls and intercellular spaces. The innermost layer of cortical cells differentiate into a cylinder called the endodermis. The radial walls of the endodermis are encrusted with waterproof lignin and suberum, forming Casparian strips. These Casparian strips are involved in controlling the minerals that enter the xylem. Minerals can cross the endodermis only if the endodermal plasma membrane absorbs them. Essentially, it keeps unpermitted minerals from going through the cracks and reaching the xylem. Interior to the cortex, a cylinder of tissue forms the stele. It consists of both the xylem and the phloem in the center. Xylem is in the center of the stele. The phloem surrounds the xylem, and no pith is present. Within the xylem, the inner wide cells are the metaxylem, the outer narrow cells are the protoxylem. Within phloem strands, the protophloem occurs on the outer side and the metaphloem occurs on the inner side. The pericycle is an irregular region of parenchyma cells between the vascular tissue and the endodermis. This is where lateral roots are produced. The number of strands of protoxylem in a root varies from one species to another and among the roots of one plant. Generally wider, the more robust roots have more protoxylem masses. The arrangement of tissue within the steel differs for monocots, as seen in C and D photos. This greenbrier root has large vessels and separate bundles of phloem, as well as a pith. In the mature portions of the root hairs function only for several days, after which they die and degenerate. Absorption of water and minerals in this area is then greatly reduced but does not stop entirely. In the endodermis, more suberum and lignin are laid over the radial and tangential surfaces. Endodermal cells that are slow to mature and have only a Casparian strip are called Paschen cells. The mature, watertight endodermis keeps water in the vascular cylinder of a mature root. Shortly after root hairs die, underlying cortex and epidermis often die. They are shed from the root. The endodermis becomes the root surface until a bark can form. The large fibrous roots of many monocots are strictly annual. They are completely replaced by more adventitious roots that are from new rhizomes or stolons. In these plants, the entire root dies. Lateral roots are initiated by cell divisions in the pericycle. Some cells of the pericycle divide and form only a small root primordium and organize it into a root apical meristem. By the time the lateral root emerges, it's formed a root cap and its first protoxylem and protophloem elements have begun to differentiate. This establishes a connection to the vascular tissues of the parent root. This concludes the internal structure of roots.